Hi and welcome to Dream Team Football, where we put XIs and all-star teams together in a retro game universe. When a South American XI is put together, it's usually just a mix of Argentinian and Brazilian players, perhaps with one or two exceptions. They have gifted the world with amazing players such as Maradona and Pelé, and have together won 8 World Cups, and have consistently been among the 5 to 10 best teams in the world since the 1970s. So how would a South American dream team look like without these two giants? Would it be competitive? Let's find out. I'm going to call the team the new Incan Republic. The Inca Empire stretched from Ecuador and Colombia in the north, covered most of today's Bolivia and Peru, and large parts of Chile in the south. So I think it would be an adequate name. Tactically, we are going with a 5-2-1-2. These nations got a handful of hard-working central midfielders that would suit this tactic well, plus they got lots of quality strikers, so it'd be a shame to do a tactic that only has one striker. Some years ago, the first choice in goal would have been easy. Claudio Bravo from Chile and Real Betis. The sweeper-keeper was first choice for Barcelona and impressed with great reflexes, good decision-making and excellent passes. He's still a decent goalkeeper, but maybe Ospina from Colombia or Muslera from Uruguay would be better. Nah, I still think I'll choose
Claudio Bravo does it again!
Even though he has turned 38 and his reflexes are not what they used to be, he's still the first choice on his national team, and David Ospina hasn't played much this season. On to the first central defender. The first player I will put in defence is Ronald Araújo from Barcelona and Uruguay. Admitted, Barcelona is in a major crisis, but when a 22-year-old defender brings himself to the world scene of football with solid defending, decent technique and an aura of leadership, it's just not possible not to choose him. So the next two. We could make it a full Uruguay central defence with José Giménez from Atletico Madrid and Sebastián from Sporting Lisbon. But I do think Gustavo Gómez from Paraguay and the Brazilian club Palmeiras deserves a spot on the team. He's strong and aggressive and overall simply a good defender, and he's even rumoured to Chelsea. Next to him, I will put
José María Giménez!
He has played under Diego Simeone in Atletico since he was a teenager. And with 73 caps for Uruguay, he got plenty of routine, tactical intelligence and a brave personality. And now on to our wingbacks. We got a good solid central defence, which means we can prioritise attacking skills. And one hell of a attacking wingback is Juan, Cuadrado from Juventus and Colombia, who will be our man in the right side. He's a superb dribbler and can pass across beautifully into the box with sublime precision. And generally, he will just be one of the best players on this team. He also got lots of routine with more than 100 caps for his national side. For the left wing back, I don't think there is such an obvious choice. It could be Matías from Uruguay, who was brought to Roma by Mourinho. Even though Mourinho is slowly losing his mind, he's still got a good eye for talent. But Viña hasn't played much this season, so I will put our first man from Ecuador on the team, Pervis Estupiñán. He plays for Villarreal in Spain. He's not a player that will take this team to new heights, but he doesn't have any obvious technical weaknesses and he's good at running, both in terms of speed, stamina and positioning. Now it gets exciting. Some hard-working central midfielders is what we need. Muscle power, stamina, aggression, all that stuff. And I will start with the guy with the best haircut. Do I even need to say his name? Arturo Vidal from Chile and Inter. He may have topped, but it's just like this tactic has been made for him with his aggressive and brave mindset and a good distribution of both attacking and defensive skills. Next to him there are a few choices. The most obvious are both from Uruguay, Federico Valverde from Real Madrid and Rodrigo Bentancur from Juventus. They're kind of similar players in terms of playing style and strengths, so it'll be a choice based on how good they have been doing this season. And since Bentancur is a regular starter for Juventus, and Valverde isn't so for Real Madrid, I will choose Bentancur. Let's move a bit further up the pitch and pick an attacking midfielder. Here we'll take a slightly different choice, and that is not to pick a player from the Qatar Stars League. No, James Rodriguez, I'm sorry, no space for you on this team. The slightly different choice is to choose a player that usually plays as a winger, Luis Díaz, also from Colombia. He got some superb success going for his club FC Porto, 12 goals in 16 matches in the league so far, 4 assists too, and good performances in Champions League. Perhaps a future real star. He's an excellent dribbler, good finisher, and fast as a UFO disappearing over the Nevada desert. Yeah, that's how fast he is. Good, good, good. Now on to the two strikers. Isn't going to be nail-biting, maybe even shoulder-biting, Luis Suarez, nail-biting. Well, I do think the Atletico and Uruguay star is one of the best strikers on the planet. So he will of course take the first spot in our striker partnership. We could unite him with a United player, Edinson Cavani, and recreate the iconic striker partnership that has helped Uruguay to many great triumphs. But I will choose Duván
Zapata
from Atalanta instead. The Colombian is strong, very strong in fact. I'm not saying he could beat Akinfenwa, but I'm not saying he couldn't. And with a lot of goals in his boots this season, 9 goals in 13 matches in Serie A, he's obviously a great finisher as well. Here is the summary of the team. While watching the summary, you could maybe take a look at the other teams I have put together. That's all from me. See you later.